of the book, Monkey on a Stick. Where did it come from, John? Why did you decide to do a book on this sect?
I'm a child of the 60s, Larry. I grew up. I remember extremely well when these people first appeared on college campuses and on city streets, and it was enlightening. Here was a Hindu religion that had come to America. I didn't know anything about it, and like most people, I went my own way, forgot about it, and then 15, 20 years later, I heard about some of the things that you've mentioned, murder, and that sort of thing, and I wondered how something that started out so good could have turned evil.
Explain the title.
Monkey on a Stick comes from a murder, Larry. It occurred here in Los Angeles on May 21st, 1986. A former Hare Krishna devotee named Steve Bryant had started a one-man crusade. He was kind of ISKCON's Bader Meinhof gang, who he was going to expose the 11 gurus who were running the movement. He put together a chaotically written expose called The Guru Business, in which there was a myriad of charges. Police, journalists around the country wrote him off because he couldn't produce any hard evidence. Then he ended up dead out here, and as a hard-bitten cop told me, he bought credibility the hard way. He died for it. He became the monkey on the stick for the movement because that's a Hindu proverb that the founder brought to this country when he brought the religion. In India, when a monkey breaks into a banana plantation, they impale him on a stick, put him outside for the other monkeys to see, and the other monkeys know to stay out of the bananas. Steve Bryant became the human monkey on the stick.
How do you explain their growth so quickly? I mean, what is it? We're only talking 33 years here, right?
23. And that's a very good question. I think it has a lot to say with what people look for in a religion. Krishna consciousness is very authoritarian. It is very rigorous. When they say no stimulants, they mean coffee. They mean no coffee, no tea. The founder came at exactly the right time, Larry. He came in 1965 when American culture was in turmoil. People were looking for new answers, for new ways to explore. I interviewed dozens of Jewish devotees and former devotees who told me that their synagogue was to them a social club. I interviewed a lot of Catholics who said that they were tired of going through the cycle of confessing their sins and then reconfessing them. And Protestants told me that the that what it took to get initiated in their church, to join their church, was so pallid that it was virtually meaningless. So along came a man who had a different way. It was very, Prabhupada was not a charismatic figure. I think that his power was really spiritual, and he laid out a new path for people to follow.
Wow.
So the religion became a bridge between East and West.